Clinging to the precipice of an imposing rock in southern Italy is the battered settlement of Cracco. It appears ancient, yet clues suggest it was home to a modern community. The seeds of its destruction were sown by its own economic success. By the 15th century, wealthy local landowners were moving into the town. As Cracco mayor Pino Lacicerchia explains,
the economic and commercial growth developed the urban center. That grew and expanded around the tower, which was itself surrounded by the houses that belonged to the landowners.
In the following centuries, Cracco's infrastructure continued to extend. As buildings sprawled down onto the surrounding slopes. Yet today, they have vanished.
A striking feature is that large parts of the new town have completely disappeared, but the old town remains largely intact, which begs the question, why then does so much of it resemble an area from a war zone?
There's a line where the old medieval settlements meet the new town. And in that new town square, it's actually sunk about 10 feet from where it used to be. The whole place has been decimated.
The answer to this odd situation can be found underground. While the medieval site is built on solid rock, the new town sits on less stable ground. This land sits on layers of different types of clay. And new infrastructure works were putting ever greater pressure on this unstable ground. The result was landslides.
A landslide is a mass movement of rock and debris that usually forms on some sort of weakness. That might be a weak bed or a join between two different types of rocks, really. Landslides are lubricated by water.
The community here always coexisted with the landslides, fixing buildings that were damaged and carrying on.
By the early 1960s, Cracco was experiencing landslides so powerful that retaining walls were constructed to keep the new town safe. But the earth continued to move.
By 1963, the landslides had caused untold damage. The entire new part of the village had slipped away down the hill. The football pitch had disappeared, and even the retaining wall that was meant to guard against landslides had gone.
Remarkably, these worsening landslides were largely self-inflicted.
They reinforced the area with concrete, which is extremely heavy and required drilling. And as a result, the added weight sped up the landslide.
They found that it was actually leaking pipes and sewers and so on that were contributing to the water that was fluxing and feeding the landslide. So it's actually a man-made problem that caused the landslides, that caused the evacuation of the town.
Landslides may have wiped out the new town, but what caused such extensive damage to the medieval parts of Cracco?
The other problem that you have in this part of the world are earthquakes. And you can imagine a solid building attached to solid rock, when that shakes, it's going to start falling apart. There was a big earthquake in 1980, and that caused major destruction with the town, and it eventually really kind of tipped it right over the edge to make it almost uninhabitable.
And this is the last abandoned house of Cracco. The last family lived here until the beginning of the 90s. Inside, you can still have signs of life, an oven, some chair on the floor, and even bottles on the fireplace.
After standing nearly 1,000 years, Krakow finally got hit with a series of calamities that it really couldn't survive.
Today, Krakow is an empty shell, a haunting destination for curious tourists. However, the town's suffering has not all been in vain.
Given all of the things that have happened to this village, it's become a bit of a mecca for scientists to try and understand exactly how you can mitigate against such problems, how you can go from a perfectly working town to a destroyed town. And hopefully we'll learn something from this, from the science into the future.